morning, dear children. Now, let us begin with unit number 1 of part A, that is partnership accounting, accounting for partnership firms. Before starting the practical portion for this, first of all, we'll be studying the theory part, that is what basically a partnership firm is, and what are the features of partnership, what accounts are prepared by a partnership firm, what is the difference between the accounting done by a sole trade firm or a partnership firm or a company. So, children, first of all, let us begin with the meaning of partnership, as we have already studied in class 11th in the forms of business organization, that a partnership firm is a group of two or more persons who join together to conduct any business for the profit motive. So, what are the essential parts of a partnership? That is, minimum 2 persons should be there. In sole trade, there is only 1 person. 1 person can do the business. But in partnership, minimum 2 persons are required and maximum it can be up to 50. The very important thing here is the partnership is governed by Indian Partnership Act 1932. Which act governs partnership? Indian Partnership Act 1932. That means all the provisions of Indian Partnership Act are applicable on the partnership firms. So, as per the section 4 of Indian Partnership Act 1932, a partnership is a group of 2 or more persons who join together to carry on a lawful business for the purpose of earning profits. What they have agreed upon? They have agreed upon to share the profits and the losses of the firm and to contribute the capital. That means all the profits and the losses of the firms will be borne by the partners, will bear by the partners in an agreed proportion, in an agreed ratio which is given, which is priorly decided, and all the partners will contribute the capital. So, jab do aur do se zyada log milkar koi ek business start karte hain, the business should be lawful. Profit motive ke liye, and they all contribute the capital and they decide a prior ratio for distributing the profits and the losses, then that particular form of an organization is known as a partnership firm. Now, let us begin with the features of partnership. We discuss the features of partnership. The very first feature is 2 or more persons. As I have told you before also, ki basically minimum 2 persons are required to carry on a business, to establish a partnership, to begin with a partnership. And the maximum number here is, the limit restricts to 50. That means not more than 50 persons can be there in a partnership firm, whether it is a banking concern or a non-banking concern. Earlier it was maximum 10 members in banking concern and 20 members in other businesses if they are doing a partnership. But now the act has restricted the maximum number to 50, that is minimum 2 persons are there and maximum 50 persons are there in case it is a banking firm or a non-banking firm. Then the second feature, children, here is agreement. Agreement means a contract. Jitne bhi members hote hain, jitne bhi persons hote hain who agree to become the partners of the firm, unke beech mein they have a contract, they have an agreement. In what is written in that agreement? The agreement specifies, the agreement defines, the agreement states all the rules and the regulations which will be followed for running the business of the partnership firm. That what will be their profit sharing ratio, what all other rules and regulations will be there, what capital amount will be contributed, and everything. This agreement can be in oral and in writing both. If partners want, they can have an oral agreement, they can have an oral contract. And if they want, they can have a written agreement also between them. That is, in writing they can have the agreement. So whenever the agreement is in a written form, the contract is in a written form, it is known as a partnership deed. And whenever it is in oral form, then it is simply an agreement. There are certain benefits that if an agreement is in a written form, that is if a partnership deed is there and if it is registered, so that we will be studying further, that what is a partnership deed basically and what are the benefits of writing a partnership deed. Then next is existence of business and a profit motive. Suppose we 2 friends are there and we are going and we are saying ki we are partners. So I am not right, because for The basic feature, the basic qualification, the basic eligibility to consider a group as a partnership is that there should be a existence of business. Means there should the business, the group should be indulged in a business activity, an economic activity, and the main motive of the group is to earn the profit. Suppose we two friends are there and we are doing social service and we are saying that we are working in a partnership. So I'm not right, because the main purpose, the main qualification for a partnership firm is that the business should be run with a profit motive. Then next is sharing of profits. So if profit motives are there, if all the partners are contributing the capital, then they will also share the profits and the losses. That means there is an agreed proportion which is being decided, priorly decided by all the partners, that what will be the ratio for the sharing of profits and losses, in what proportion they will share. Sometimes they share equally, sometimes they share in an agreed proportion which is priorly decided. So every loss, every profit is shared in that particular ratio. Then next is business is carried on by all or any of them acting for all. बिजनेस क्या होता है, पार्टनरशिप क्या होती है, उसमें सारे पर्सन जो होते हैं वो सब काम करना चाहे तो कर सकते हैं, या कोई एक पर्सन चाहे तो वो भी सबके लिए वर्क कर सकते हैं. दैट मीन्स इफ एनी पर्सन वॉन्ट्स टू एक्ट, ही कैन एक्ट अकॉर्डिंगली फॉर ऑल, एंड इफ ऑल वॉन्ट्स दे ऑल कैन वर्क. बट इसमें ये कंडीशन होती है कि इफ आई एम डूइंग समथिंग और मुझसे अगर कुछ गलत हुआ है तो माई एक्ट इज बाइंडिंग अपॉन ऑल द अदर पार्टनर्स. देन द नेक्स्ट इज relationship of principal and agent. That means each partner is a principal for other partners and each partner is an agent for the other partners also. So how he is a principal? He is a principal when other partners' acts are binding upon him. Means agar kuch aur koi partner kar raha hai aur uske acts agar mujh pe bound ho rahe hain, then that means I am acting as a principal. But if my acts are binding on other partners, that means I am acting as an agent. So at the same time, I am acting as a principal also and I am acting as an agent also. So every partner in the partnership firm acts as a principal and as an agent. So these are the certain characteristics which basically a partnership firm possess. Our next topic is children, partnership deed. That what basically a partnership deed. Yes children, now partnership deed. What is a partnership deed? As I told you before that there is an agreement between the partners which can be in oral or in written form. Oral can be we have agreed, hum do friends hain and humne baat kar li ki haan hum aise aise business karenge and you will share half of the profit, I'll share half of the profit, you will bring this much of capital, I'll bring this much of capital aur humne business karna start kar diya. एग्रीमेंट हुआ है लेकिन सिर्फ बातचीत में एग्रीमेंट हुआ है, दिस इज अ सॉर्ट ऑफ अ ओरल एग्रीमेंट. लेकिन इसमें क्या होता है, मिसअंडरस्टैंडिंग्स होने के चांसेस होते हैं, डिस्प्यूट्स होने के चांसेस होते हैं. तो इट इज बेटर कि हम क्या करते हैं, दैट एग्रीमेंट इज इन अ रिटन फॉर्म, वी राइट द एग्रीमेंट एंड वी गेट इट रजिस्टर्ड सो दैट देर आर लेस चांसेस ऑफ मिसअंडरस्टैंडिंग्स एंड लेस चांसेस ऑफ डिस्प्यूट्स. तो व्हेनेवर द अग्रीमेंट, द कॉन्ट्रैक्ट ऑफ पार्टनरशिप comes in a written form, then that particular written agreement between the partners is known as a partnership deed. Iske certain contents are there ki what is written in the partnership deed, and if partnership deed is there what happens, and if partnership deed is not there what happens. So children, what are the contents of partnership deed? Name of the firm is written, address of the firm is written, name of the partners is written, address of the partners is written, unka kya proportion hoga, in what proportion they will share the profits and losses, then wo interest on drawings unko kitne rate se diya jayega, interest on capital unko kitne rate se diya jayega, unke interest on loan ka kya percentage hoga, किस पार्टनर को कितनी सैलरी देनी है, किस पार्टनर को कितना कमीशन देना है, एवरीथिंग. क्या ऑडिटिंग की कब होगी, कैसे होगी, कौन कौन से अकाउंट्स बनाए जाएंगे, एवरीथिंग इज मेंशन्ड इन दैट रिटन एग्रीमेंट विच इज नोन एज पार्टनरशिप डीड. तो दिस इज द कंटेंट ऑफ द पार्टनरशिप डीड. अब उसमें सब कुछ मेंशन होता है रिगार्डिंग इंटरेस्ट ऑन कैपिटल, इंटरेस्ट ऑन ड्रॉइंग. इंटरेस्ट ऑन कैपिटल फर्म पार्टनर्स को देती है एंड इंटरेस्ट ऑन ड्रॉइंग्स फर्म पार्टनर्स से लेती है. मैंने पैसा लगाया दैट इज कैपिटल, उस पर मुझे फर्म इंटरेस्ट दे रही है दैट इज इंटरेस्ट ऑन कैपिटल। मैंने फर्म से पैसा अपने पर्सनल यूजेज के लिए निकाला है, उस पर फर्म मुझसे इंटरेस्ट ले रही है दैट इज इंटरेस्ट ऑन ड्रॉइंग्स। तो इंटरेस्ट ऑन ड्रॉइंग्स इज अ इनकम फॉर द फर्म एंड इंटरेस्ट ऑन कैपिटल इज एन एक्सपेंस फॉर द फर्म। तो अगर पार्टनरशिप डीड है तो उसमें जितना रेट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट मेंशन है उतने रेट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट से सारी चीजें होती हैं। वट एवर द रेट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट इज मेंशन इन द डीड ओनली दैट मच रेट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट इज एप्लीकेबल ऑन द इंटरेस्ट एंड ऑन द ड्रॉइंग्स। बट वट हैपन्स इन द एब्सेंस ऑफ द डीड, अगर डीड नहीं है तो क्या रूल्स अप्लाई होते हैं? दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट चिल्ड्रन। इफ देयर इज नो डीड, इफ डीड इज एब्सेंट, देन व्हाट हैपेंस? द वेरी फर्स्ट पॉइंट टू बी रिमेंबर इज दैट इफ देयर इज नो डीड द प्रॉफिट्स एंड द लॉसेस विल बी शेयर्ड इक्वली। मींस इफ नथिंग इज मेंशन इन द क्वेश्चन दैट इन व्हाट प्रपोर्शन देयर आर शेयरिंग द प्रॉफिट्स, देन close your eyes and distribute the profits and losses everything equally. Suppose if question mein likha hai A and B are two partners sharing profits and losses in the ratio of 3:2. So if 3:2 is mentioned or 2:1 is mentioned or 4:5 is mentioned or 3:4 is mentioned, that means you have to distribute everything in this particular proportion. But if nothing is mentioned, if it is only written that A and B are partners in a partnership firm, nothing is mentioned, that means there is absence of partnership deed and you have to distribute the profits and losses equally, in equal proportion. If three partners are there, 1:1:1, that is 1/3, 1/3, 1/3. If two partners are there, then 1:1, that is 1/2 and 1/2 equally. Then the second important point which is to be kept in mind in the absence of partnership deed is that no interest on capital is allowed by the firm to the partners. Again I repeat, agar partnership deed nahi hai to partners ki capital par interest nahi diya jayega. Clear? Then point number 3 is interest on drawings. If partnership deed is not there, then no interest on drawings will be charged by the partners. मैंने drawings किया है लेकिन deed नहीं है, तो partners से कोई भी interest नहीं लिया जाएगा. No interest, not charged. Then next is salary and commission. Suppose a partner is entitled towards salary or a commission and deed is not there. So in that case, no salary and commission will be given to the partner. That means, agar salary or commission hum dete hain par deed nahi hai, to hum salary or commission bhi nahi denge. And the last important point is related with interest on loan. So interest on loan mein kya hota hai bache? Ki agar aap ne partner se loan liya hai aur deed nahi hai, tab bhi aapko usko interest लोन पर इंटरेस्ट देना पड़ेगा एंड उसके लिए एक परसेंटेज डिसाइडेड है विच इज 6% पर एनम। अगर डीड है तो डीड में जितना मेंशन है आप उतना देते हो, बट इफ डीड इज नॉट देयर देन इंटरेस्ट इज गिवन एट द रेट ऑफ 6% पर एनम इन रिस्पेक्टिव ऑफ द पीरियड। आप उसको 6% पर एनम का इंटरेस्ट दोगे। तो दीज आर द सर्टेन पॉइंट्स विच आर टू बी केप्ट इन माइंड। दीज 5 पॉइंट्स आर टू बी केप्ट इन माइंड। If there is no partnership deed, that is profits and losses are shared equally, no interest on capital is given, no interest on drawings is charged, no salary, no commission is given, and the last is if loan is there, then at the rate of 6% per annum interest on loan is given to the partner. Then our next topic is children. Now children, our next topic is distribution of profits and losses to the partners. कि हम कैसे प्रॉफिट्स और लॉसेस को डिस्ट्रीब्यूट करेंगे। चिल्ड्रन, सोल प्रोप्राइटरशिप में क्या होता था? व्हाट हैपन कि वहां पर डायरेक्टली वी ट्रांसफर द प्रॉफिट्स टू द कैपिटल ऑफ द सोल ट्रेडर। दैट मींस कि वहां पर फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी प्रिपेयर ट्रेडिंग अकाउंट, देन प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस अकाउंट इज प्रिपेयर, एंड थर्ड स्टेटमेंट विच वॉज प्रिपेयर इज बैलेंस शीट, एंड इन दैट बैलेंस शीट द प्रॉफिट्स एंड द लॉसेज वर ट्रांसफर टू द कैपिटल डायरेक्टली बिकॉज देयर वॉज ओनली वन पर्सन हु वॉज द ओनर। Here in partnership, there are many owners. That means it can be 2, it can be 3, it can be 10, 50. So there are many owners, and each owner has the right to take a share in the profits because he has contributed the capital too. So what happened here, for distributing the profits and losses in the partnership, we prepare an account which is known as profit and loss appropriation account. Appropriation itself states that dividing and distributing. So profits and loss appropriation account is distributing and appropriating the profits and losses. आप क्या कर रहे हो? Divide कर रहे हो. So for distributing that profit and loss, the account which is prepared is known as profit and loss appropriation account. What happens in sole trade? First of all, trading account is prepared. From that, gross profit or gross loss is calculated. In the same manner, in partnership also, trading is prepared, gross profit and gross loss is calculated. After that, that gross profit and loss is transferred to P&L. In the same manner, it also happens in partnership, that gross profit and gross loss is transferred to P&L account. And uske baad wahan kya hota tha? Directly it goes to the capital in the balance sheet, and it was added, profits are added and losses are deducted. But here what happens, here you have to distribute that profit or that loss to the number of partners who are there in the firm. So for distributing that profit and loss, you prepare a new account which is known as profit and loss appropriation account, and this is prepared just after closing of profit and loss account. तो वहां क्या करते थे, वहां से जो नेट प्रॉफिट और नेट लॉसेस होते थे आप कैपिटल में ट्रांसफर करते थे. बट यहां आप क्या करोगे, नेट प्रॉफिट्स और नेट लॉसेस को पीएनएल एप्रोप्रिएशन अकाउंट में ट्रांसफर करोगे. एंड पार्टनर्स को जो भी देना है एंड पार्टनर्स से जो भी लेना है, आई एम नॉट टॉकिंग अबाउट द फर्म, मैं फर्म की इनकम्स और एक्सपेंसेस की बात नहीं कर रही, आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट पार्टनर्स. व्हाटसोएवर इज टू बी गिवन टू द पार्टनर्स एंड व्हाटसोएवर इज टू बी टेकन फ्रॉम द पार्टनर्स is recorded in this account. So first of all children, the net profit from that profit and loss account is transferred here. So profit is transferred from here to here. So we'll write by net profit, or we can write it as by P&L account. We write it as by P&L account because we close P&L account. So we write by P&L account. If profit is there and to P&L account, if net loss is there. If losses are there, we write P&L in debit side, and if profits are there, we write P&L on the credit side. Now it is a nominal nature account. Whatsoever is to be taken from the partners will be written on the credit side, and whatsoever is to be given to the partners will be written on the debit side. So first of all, to interest on capital, suppose two partners are there, A and B, then to salary or commission, then if you have transferred anything from the profits to the reserves, that is also written to reserves, then interest on drawings, by interest on drawings. It is an income because partners will give the interest, A and B. Now what happens, आप इससे calculate करते हो difference. If this side is more and this side is less, that there is a profit on appropriation which will be distributed to the partners in their profit sharing ratio. अगर question में है तो उस ratio में, if it is not given in the question, then equal. तो we will close this account to partners capital account A and B in their ratio. अगर profits है तो यहां आएंगे, and it can be if losses are there, means if this side is more than this side, then it will be by partners capital account A and B. So it will be written here, and then we'll close this. Children, appropriation में जाने के साथ साथ ये जो particular items होते हैं, ये partner के capital accounts में भी जाते हैं. For this, general entries are done. That means for interest on capital. Interest on capital अगर business के लिए expense है तो partner के लिए income है. अगर appropriation के debit side में तो it means capital account के credit side में जाएगा. तो for these items, what entries are done for interest on capital? It is interest on capital account debit to partners. Capital account for salaries, the same entries passed salary to partners capital. या आप दे रहे हो partner के capital account में भी show करोगे, मतलब appropriation के बाद partners के capital account बनते हैं जिसमें ये सब items दिखाए जाते हैं, salary और commission. Then interest on drawings के लिए क्या entry होती है, वो partner देगा तो partner के account में debit side में जाएगा, तो it will be interest partners capital account debit, partners capital account debit to interest on drawings account. तो these are the then ये profits की entry होती है, profits होते हैं तो partner के capital account के credit side में जाते हैं and if losses होते हैं तो partner के capital account के debit side में जाते हैं. तो profits के लिए entry होती है children P&L appropriation account debit to partners capital account and reverse entry is done for the losses. That means partners capital account debit to P&L appropriation account. देखो entry कैसे बन रही है, P&L appropriation के credit side में जा रहा है partner capital. इसका मतलब entry में P&L appropriation will be credited and what will be debited? Partners capital account. So for losses the entry is reversed. Entry is partners capital account debit to P&L appropriation account. So children, these are the certain entries which are done for the capital accounts and इसके लिए भी you can prepare the entries. But basically this account is prepared. So now